Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss separable programming problem. Friends, I had already discussed this in Hindi. If you want to watch this video in Hindi, I had provided link in the description. Friends, I suggest you please watch this video step by step till end. I am sure you will understand this question. If still you have problem, you can contact me. I had provided my WhatsApp number in the description. Now let us start. First of all, we will discuss what is a separable programming problem. If the objective function of non-linear programming problem can be expressed as a linear combination of several one variable. Okay, that is, if we can express objective function of non-linear programming problem as a linear combination of several different single variable function of which some or all are non-linear, then such a non-linear programming problem is called separable programming problem. Now we discuss two important terms which we use in this question, that is concave and convex. If the non-linear function f of x is of minimization type, okay, then we can say that it is convex, okay, and if it is of maximization type, we can say that it is concave. Okay friends, now let us start with an example. Here the objective function is maximize z, which is equal to 3x1 plus 2x2. Here the function is of maximization, that means it is concave. Okay, constants are 4x1 square plus 4x2 square less than or equal to 16. Okay, x1 x2 greater than 0. Now the first step is convert the minimization objective function of given non-linear programming problem into maximization. Here the objective function is already of maximization type. Okay, so now we consider the separable function f1 x1 which is equal to 3x1, okay, and then f2 x2 2x2, and then g11 x1 which is equal to 4x1 square, and g12 x2 which is equal to x2 square. Since the function satisfy the concavity condition, okay, because this function is a concave function, our second step is examine whether the function fj, xj and gj, xj satisfy the concavity condition. We have already discussed that this function will satisfy the concavity conditions. If yes, proceed to the step number 3. Now we will proceed to the step number 3. First of all, divide the interval 0 less than or equal to xj into number of breaking points. Now we have to divide the interval into breaking points. First of all, we will derive the interval. Okay, so by inspection we will find the value of x1 and x2 from this constant. When I will put the value of x2 is equal to 0, I will get 4x1 square less than or equal to 16. Okay, that is x1 is equal to 2. And then when I will put x1 is equal to 0, I will get x2 is equal to 4. Okay, so I had written here, by inspection we will get x1 less than or equal to 2 and x2 less than or equal to 4. Okay, the greatest value, I will consider the greatest value as a upper limit for x1 and x2, and we will denote it by t1 is equal to 4 and t2 is equal to 4 as the upper limit for the variable x1 and x2 respectively. Now I had formulated the interval which is 0 to 4. Okay, I have to divide this interval into breaking points. Here the breaking points are AJK, where k is equal to 1 to k term, such that AJ1 is equal to 0 and AJ1 less than AJ2, strictly less than AJ3, and so on AJK term. Here we will divide the closed interval 0 to 4 into 4 sub intervals. Okay, it's our choice how many sub interval we are going to divide this. Okay, and I have take the 4 sub intervals of 0 to 4. That is, the first interval I take 0 to 1, then I take 1 to 2, then I take 2 to 3, and then I take 3 to 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 subintervals. Okay, of equal size, these are of equal size. Now we have to obtain the approximate linear programming problem for the given NLPP. Okay, so we will divide 0 to 4, that is closed interval 0 to 4, into 5 breaking points. Now we have to discuss why we will divide this into 5 breaking points. Okay, I will tell you friends. See here, we have taken 0 1 2 3 4, first interval, second interval, third interval and fourth interval. Okay, we have 4 sub intervals, so we will divide this into 5 breaking point. Why we will divide into 5 breaking point? Because in the method we have discussed that k will be started from 1, okay, and j will start from, sorry, k will be started from 1, okay, and j is the number of variables, okay, which is x1 and x2, that is 1 and 2. Now here the first one is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, that are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. I had 5 breaking points corresponding to the 4 sub intervals, okay, corresponding to the 4 sub interval I will get 4 breaking points. This is a very important step in this question. If you will understand this step, then you will understand the whole question. And if you have any problem, you can ask me in the WhatsApp. So I had taken 5 breaking point corresponding to the 4 sub intervals. So I had written here AJK, which is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And this will satisfy the property AJ1 strictly less than AJ2, strictly less than AJ3, strictly less than AJ4 and so on. Okay. And here the K is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay friends. Now I have to find F1, X1 for this F1, X1, which is equal to, from the above table, which is equal to 3x1. Here is 3x1. Okay. Now, for x1 is equal to AJK. Okay. So, I will get value corresponding to this, which is equal to 3 into AJK. That is 3 into 0, which is equal to 0. Then, 3 into 1, which is equal to 3. And so on. 3 into 2, I will get 6, then 3 into 3, I will get 9, and then 3 into 4, I will get 12. Okay, friends. In the same way, for x2, f2, x2, here the value of f2, x2 is equal to 2x2. So I will get from here f2, x2, which is equal to 2x2. Now I will consider x2 as AJK, that is 2 into AJK. So I will multiply the value of AJK by 2 and I will get the desired result for this column. So 2 multiplied by 0, that is 0. 2 multiplied by 1, which is equal to 2. 2 multiplied by 4, which is equal to 4. 2 multiplied by 3, 6. 2 multiplied by 4, that is 8. Okay. In the same way, I will find G11, X1. Here the G11, X1 is, which is equal to 4X1 square. Now I will consider x1 as is equal as AJK, that is 4 AJK square. Okay. Here AJK is 0, that is 4 multiplied by 0 square, which is equal to 0. In the same way, I will get the next values, that is 4 multiplied by 1 square, which is equal to 4. Then 4 multiplied by 2 square, 2 to 4. And then 4 is equal to 16. Then 2, 4 multiplied by 3 square, which I will get 36. Then 4 multiplied by this 4 square, I will get 64. Okay friends. In the same way, I will find out the value of AJ12. AG12, sorry. Which is X2 ka square. I will consider X2 as AJK. Okay. So I will get 0 square, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, that is 9, 4 square, that is 16. Okay, so this is our desired table. Friends, if you have any doubt, you can ask me, because this is very important in this question. from this table we have following piecewise linear approximation. Okay, first of all I will find for f1 x1. Here I had taken w a j k as a weight function. Okay, where j is equal to number of variable and k is equal to 1 to 5. Okay friends, so here w will be w11, w12, w13, w14 and w15. Okay, and the values of x1s are these are the coefficient of these variables. Okay, here the coefficients of here the values of f1 x1s are 0, 3, 6, 9 and 12. So 0, 3, 6, 9 and 12. In the same way for x f of 2 x2, here w21, because x2 is equal to 2, that is j is equal to 2. So here is w21, w22, w23, w24 and w25. Okay, and the values of x2 are the coefficient of this variable, that is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. In the same way for g11, here j is equal to 1, that is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. And the coefficients of these variables are the value of column g11, that is 0, 4, 16, 36, 64. Okay, in the same way for g1, g1 to x2. Okay, from this. Now we will formulate the approximating linear programming problem from the above values. Here the maximum f of z, that is the objective function, which is equal to from this 3x1 plus 2x2. Here f1 x1 is equal to 3x1 and f2 x2 is equal to 2x2. That is objective function will be f of x1 plus f of x2. So I had written here objective function f of x1 plus f of x2. Here the value of f of x1 plus the value of f of x2. Okay, and the constants are g of x is equal to 4x1 square plus x2 square less than 16. I had considered g of 11 x1 is equal to 4x1 square and g of 12 x2 is equal to x2 square. It means that constant will be g11 x1 plus g12 x2 less than or equal to 16. So I had written here g11 x1 this value plus g12 x2 this value less than or equal to 16. And then I will consider w11, w12, w13, w14 and w15 is equal to 1 and w21, w22, w23, w24, w25 is equal to 1. Okay, I will consider these two constants. Now I will solve this problem, the resulting problem, by using two phase simplex method with these two additional constants. Okay, the additional conditions, the first condition is for each j no more than 2 wjk are positive. It means that no more than 2 wjk will be in the basic variable. Okay, and the second one is if 2 wjk are positive, it means that if 2 jk are in the basis, then they must be corresponding to adjacent points. Means if any 2 wjk more than 2 wjk are in the basis, then they should be adjacent to each other. Okay friends, now I will solve this by using two phase simplex method. This is our step number 6 and I will consider wi1 as an artificial variable. Here the wi1 is w11 and w21, w11 and w21, that is I will consider w11 and w21 as an artificial variable. And in the standard form of this variable, I had added slack variable, that is s1, in this constant, and I will get s1 as a slack variable. This is the desired table from this problem. As usual, we do cj is 3, 6, 9, 12, 2 and so on. That is from here 3, 6, 9. Here the variable in the basis are s1 and 2 artificial variable. So I had written 2 artificial variable and s1 in this table here separate, and all other values here. Okay, and then I find cj minus zj. Okay, that is 3, 6, 9, 12 and so on. Now the solution is not optimal. The solution will be optimal if cj minus zj is less than or equal to 0. these dot dot denote zero. Okay, friends. So in maximize, this is the maximization problem. I will choose the biggest value from CJ minus ZJ. Here the biggest value is 12. That means W15 will enter into the basis. Now I have to select the variable which will be removed from the basis. Okay, for this I will find the minimum ratio. So if I will find the minimum ratio, I will get the first one is 16 by 64. Okay, I will get value in 0 point something. Okay, and then 1 divided by 1, it means that, and this will be not defined, it means that this is the minimum ratio, this is the minimum value. Corresponding to this is S1, that is S1 will be removed from basis, and in place of S1 I will get W15 into the basis. But this will not satisfy the additional condition that no more than 2 JK will enter into the basis if they are not adjacent. Here these two are adjacent, but if W15 will enter into the basis, I will get 15 which is not adjacent to any point W11 and W12. It means that this will not enter into the basis. Now I have to select the next greater element. The next greater element is 9, and corresponding to 9 I will find the minimum ratio, this, and corresponding to this I will get W14 into the basis. Still W14 is not adjacent to any point. It means that W14 will also not enter into the basis. Now I have to proceed to the next value, and the next one is 8. Okay, I will find the minimum ratio for this column. Here the first one is 16 divided by 16. I will get 1, and then 1 divided by 0, that is not defined, and then 1 divided by 1. Okay, here is 1 and here is 1. Okay, now we have to choose any value. If I will choose this value, x1, s1 will leave from basis, but this will not satisfy the additional condition that W25 is adjacent to any of this function. So this will not enter into the basis. So I will choose this value, that is W25, which will enter into the basis. Okay, here I will get then only 2 WGAs. Okay, so I had written here the next best variable to enter into the basis is W25, and variable W21 will leave the basis. Okay, now by usual process I will solve this table. Okay, I have to make this one. Okay, as we do in simplex table. If you have not understand this problem, I had provided the link in the description of two-phase simplex method. Okay, you can watch from there in detail. Here I have to make this one, so I will divide this row by so this row will be same, no change, and then I have made here 0, no change, and then here 16 I have to made here 0. So I will multiply this one by 16 and then subtract from this, and so on. Okay, here you have to remember one thing, that W12 has been removed from basis, and W12 is an artificial variable. So I will not write W12 in this table. Okay friends, here still the solution is not feasible. Sorry, still the solution is not optimal. So I will proceed to next table. Here CJ minus ZJ, the greatest value is 12, and corresponding 12 is 64. So I will get the minimum ratio. First one I will get 0, second one 1, that is the minimum will be first. Corresponding to first, S1 will be removed from basis, and W15 will enter into the basis, but this will not satisfy the condition, additional condition, that no more than 2 WJK will enter into the basis. If they will enter into the basis, they should be adjacent, but W15 is not adjacent to any of these two point. Okay, so W12 will not enter into the basis. Now we have to proceed to the next value. Here the next value is 9, and here the minimum ratio still will be this value. Corresponding to this will be S1. W14 is still not a adjacent variable, so this will also not enter into the basis. And then I will proceed to the next value, 6, still same, this will not enter into the basis. This is not also the adjacent, and the according to this value, there is also not, this is not adjacent to any of these point. Okay, now the next value is this one. Here I will get this value. Okay, 5 because this is negative, I will not take negative value. Here this is also not adjacent, sorry, here the minimum value will be 0 divided by minus 12. That is W13 will replace in place of WS1, but still there is more than 2 WJs and WKs, and this will not satisfy the additional condition of being adjacent. So I will proceed to the next value, and the next value will be 3, and corresponding to this I will get this one. Okay, if I will replace this and W12 will be adjacent to W11, okay, because W11 and W12 are adjacent points. Okay, this will satisfy the additional condition. So this variable will be entering into the basis, and X1 will remove from the braces, and I will simplify this table as usual by simplex method. Here I will get the next value. Here x1 will be removed from the basis, and x1 is not an artificial variable, so I will write here s. Okay, s1 is here the variable in the basis, I had written here, and so on. Okay, here cj minus zj still are not all negative. Okay, so I will again proceed to the next step. Here the biggest value is 5. Corresponding to 5, I will find the minimum ratio. First I will get 0. 0 will be the minimum. Okay, corresponding to this value, W23 will enter into the basis, but W23 is not corresponding to any of this point. Okay, so W23 will not enter into the basis. Okay friends, now the next value is next biggest value is 21/4, and the minimum ratio will be 0 divided by -15/4. Okay, still W22 is not corresponding to any of this value. Okay, it means that this will not enter into the basis. Okay friends, and now the next value is 13/4. Okay, here the minimum ratio will be this value. You have to remember this is a very important step, 0 divided by -7/4. Okay friends, but if I will choose this value W12 to come in place of W23, W24, this will not be adjacent to W11. So I will choose, and if I will proceed to the next value, the next values are negative values. Okay friends, so I will choose 7/4, and corresponding to this I will choose W11. Okay, so W24 will enter in place of W11. Okay, and W24 is adjacent to W25. Okay friends, so I had chosen this W21 to enter into the basis, and W11 to leave from the basis. Okay friends, here I get the desired result. This is the last table I had constructed, and here all CJ minus ZJ are less than 0. Okay friends, this is a optimal solution. Since all CJ minus ZJ are less than 0, the optimal solution has been obtained. Here W12 is equal to 1, W24 is equal to 4/7, and W25 is equal to 3/7, and f of x, I will put all these value in this maximum f of x, and I will get f of x is equal to 69/7. Okay friends, now I have to find the optimal solution for the original nonlinear programming problem. For this we are given with the method, that is xj is equal to k goes to 1 to k theorem. Here k is from 1 to 5 ajk. Okay friends, here j is equal to 1 and 2. So first of all I will find for 1, x1, a11, w1 and so on. Okay, these are the value from this. Here a11, a12, I will put the value from this table, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and the value of w11, here the value of w1 is 1, 2 is equal to 1, and all other values are 0. So I have written here, I will get 1, and then x2 written here, and here W24 and W25 are 4/7 and 3/7. I had put here 4/7 and 3/7. All other values of A1, A2 I will get from this table. I will get x2 is equal to 24/7. Okay friends, and then I will put the value of x1 and x2 in the original objective function, which is equal to 3x1 plus 2x2. I will get the desired answer. So friends, if you like my video, please subscribe my channel and share this video. Thanks for watching.